Good morning, happy Friday, and welcome to our virtual live performance matinee of Squids Will Be Squids. This morning, we are doing a funny take on fairy tales and fables, and we're so glad that you are here. One of our things that's real important to us at TYT is, I often say in rehearsals, I give you something small as an actor, and you make it bigger on your own. And this week, students have been working on their own. And what we've been working on are three big goals. Number one, we have been working on who are you and what are you doing as your character? Number two, we've been working on how will you use your imagination, body, and voice as an actor? And number three, and most importantly, what ideas do you have? That's real important here. For us at TYT, we tend to collaborate, share ideas, and we often ask, what ideas do you have? And I'm really excited to share all of their ideas with you today. You'll hear me say a lot in rehearsals, I trust that you are the experts, and these experts are here and ready to give you a comedy live performance of Squids Will Be Squids. And so I just want to say a quick thank you to Alana and Mr. Dave and to Miss Steph, and also to all the parents who helped and all the actors who helped create some wacky, wacky costumes. So sit back, relax. Thank you all again for coming. Enjoy our comedy of Squids Will Be Squids. And everyone, places, please, and cue up the sound cue.
Stories about cute widow animals that are used to demonstrate a moral, like in The Tortoise and the Hare. Ah, you know that one, do you? And do you know what a moral is? A moral is a little lesson about what is right and what is wrong. In the story of The Tortoise and the hare challenges the tortoise to a race. Knowing he was way faster than the tortoise, he took a nap halfway through. Well, lo and behold, when he woke up, there was a tortoise crossing the finish line. Of course, the moral here is, never race a tortoise, because they hide rockets in their shells and are actually really, really fast.
Psst. No. Just, no. It's not even close.
Yes, it is. Rocket shells, that's a thing.
No, it most certainly is not a thing.
Yeah, it is. Maybe American tortoises don't have rockets, but they totally have them in Europe.
There are no rocket-powered tortoises.
There totally are.
There totally are it.
Well, that's your opinion.
No, it's science.
Well, comme ci, comme ça.
Do you even know what that means?
Can you fait rien, isn't it?
You can't just say random things in French and hope you'll win the argument.
Crème brûlée, Shane's Lounge, Bon Appetit, Tête à Tarte.
That's not even French. You just sound ridiculous.
So, anyways, fables. Fables have been around for thousands of years, and it's no wonder, because even thousands of years ago, people were bright enough to figure out that you could gossip about anybody as long as you change their name to something like lion, or mouse, or donkey.
Or squid. Don't forget about squid. And now we have our first story. Actors ready? And scene change music, please.
There was once a palm tree by an ocean, and in the palm tree lived a stink bug. In the nearby ocean lived a squid.
Hey, squid, what's up, fish?
What's that supposed to mean, small sir?
At least I don't ink every time an animal comes near.
At least I ain't skinny and have antennas.
How dare you make fun of these beauties? At least I ain't like you, because I ain't fat or whip.
How rude! Talk to the inky tentacles, stink bug.
At least I live high up in this gorgeous, beautiful palm tree, and not down in the wet ocean with you.
At least I can dine with you, and you'll be the main course.
Oh no, you did not just do that.
Yes, I just did. At least I'm at the top of the food chain.
At least I can run away with a squeaky voice and a good rap.
I think we should be friends.
No way. I have a reputation, and that would so ruin it, punk.
Please, 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 with inky strip on top, please, come on, please.
Fine. It means so much to you. Fine. Come on, let's shake on it. Ew, you got inky slime on me. Wait a minute. I can't swim. No, I'm drowning. Help, help, no.
Yummy, yummy, yummy.
Let's say the squid was satisfied, the stink bug, not so much. The end.
Hey, I found this wandering around backstage.
Right, thanks. Hey, since you're here, will you hold this?
Sure. Wait, wait, where are you going?
It's my brick. I'm going to grab my bike.
What? We are in the middle of a show.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I know. Bummer. Well, I'll see you later. Be back in a few.
Okay. So, how you doing? Where were we? Where were we? Ah, yes. Next up is he who smelt it, dealt it. Is the story of Skunk, Ox, and Cabbage. Cabbage? That's not even an animal!
Yeah, and I'm a cruciferous vegetable and I'm very good for you. You have a problem with that? I am low in saturated fat and cholesterol and can cure stomach ulcers. People love me in coleslaw. Can you even make coleslaw? I look great in purple and green.
Okay, okay, I'm sorry.
And that's not all, mister. I can be fried, stewed, or steamed. I am packed with vitamins K and C. If you mess with me, I'll have my cousins bok choy, Romanesco, and leafy red come find you.
Okay, all right. I'm picking up what you're putting down. I read you. So sorry. Back to the story. So, Skunk, Ox, and Miss Cabbage were sitting around the front porch having a snack at Skunk's house when, slowly but surely, the porch filled up with a terrible smell.
Whoa! Is that you, Ox?
No way! No, That there is Cabbage.
It's not me.
And the moral, he who smelt it, dealt it. Well, yeah, I guess that makes sense. Big gulp, huh?
Yep.
You feeling better? Did you have a good break?
Yes, actually, I was in the bathroom and I read this really great article about the weirdest boy on Earth named AJ Winoni.
Wow, coolest story, bro. Your turn.
All right, I'm back, guys. Hi, Jean out there. Hi, moms and dads. How are you? All right, good, good. Okay, and now for the story of our good friends, Matches and Straw. It was the end of summer vacation. Straw had done everything he could think of, but now he was just bored. So, he decided to go play with someone that he'd been warned time and time again to stay away from.
Hi, do you want to play checkers with me?
Sure, but I get to be the red ones, and I get to move first. And I get two moves, and you only get one, okay?
Never mind. How about we just play ping pong instead?
Okay. I get the good paddle, though, and you have to stand way over there. Also, you have to close one eye. But you can close both if you want to.
I don't feel like I want to take that offer. Thank you very much. Never mind. Let's just watch TV.
Hi. You sit over there on the floor. I get the couch and I get the remote. And we get to watch all my favorite TV shows.
What's that, Mom? Uh-huh. Yeah, okay, I'll be right there. I think I hear my mom calling, so I gotta go. I'm out of here.
Oh, man.
And the moral is, don't play with matches.
Excuse me, hello? Anybody out there?
Of course, little Walrus. Sorry I was out grabbing a Dunkin' Refresher with strawberry, dragon fruit, kiwi, lime with three escapes only, and a dash of peach packing fruit. That's little Walrus. Little Walrus's mom told her to always tell the truth. Isn't that right, little Walrus?
That's right, pigeon breath.
Pigeon!
Hello? Walrus residence.
Hello, little Walrus. Is your mom home?
No, she's out having the hair taken off her lip.
The moral here is you should always tell the truth. But if your mom is out having the hair taken off her lip, you might want to forget a few of the details.
Just you wait till I get home!
Une belle journée and soleil.
I don't understand what you just said. And our audience at home probably doesn't either. You sound like Lumiere. That is a different show. You need to start again.
Une belle journée and soleil.
Oh, no, no. Yeah, this isn't Disney. Or Disney Plus. It's Fables. Simple fables with a little name changing. And a little intro like Once Upon a Time to begin each little fable. Get it? Got it? Good. Cue the morning fire music, please!
fine, I'll start again. Once upon a time, on a bright sunny afternoon, Grasshopper dropped his backpack and was just about to run outside to meet his friends.
Where are you going?
Out to meet some friends.
Do you have any homework to do tomorrow?
Just one small thing for history. I did the rest in class.
Okay, be back at 6 for dinner, dear.
Grasshopper hung out with his friends, came home promptly at 6, and ate his dinner.
Okay, let's take a look at this homework. Rewrite 12 Greek myths as Broadway musicals. Write music for songs. Tape out a character description list using all new vocabulary words. Design a Kahoot listing items found in Pandora's box. Construct a diorama for all the things Midas touched that turned to gold. Design and build all sets using straws and Q-tips only. Sew an original costume for the mythological animal with a single horn on its head known as the unicorn. No white glitter allowed. Wait! How long have you known about this assignment?
I don't know.
Moral, there are plenty of things to say to calm a hopping mad grasshopper mom, but I don't know, he's not one of them. All right, well, I think I'm good. In today's presentation of Fables, you have seen all kinds of bossy, sneaky, funny, annoying, kind of disgusting, dim bulb people. I mean animals.
Cabbage is not an animal.
You're right. Les choux les légumes les plus délicieux. Cespon en soup.
I hate you!
Oh, you know you love me. In fact, Aesop, you used to tell this one fable about a real bossy jerk lion who ruled the city.
Yeah. That one was great.
Well, when the real bossy jerk guy who ruled Aesop City heard this fable, he didn't like it.
Uh-oh.
So he had Aesop thrown off a cliff.
He what? Hey, why are you looking at me like that? What are you doing? Don't you dare think of picking me up it!
And our final moral this evening is...
But if you're planning to write fables...
Don't forget to change people into animals.
And, most importantly, avoid places with high cliffs.
Thank you and au revoir.
Au revoir.
Congratulations to the cast. That was a well done performance today. I'm still laughing. Thank you all for joining us. Audience members at home, please make sure you check out our homepage, our Facebook page. We have some high school productions coming up. We still have some more camp sessions coming up. So please visit us and come back again to TYT. Congratulations, and we'll see you soon.